These ropes often move. They will often unravel themselves. They'll throw themselves out here in the path. There's one over on the other side I'll show you that was put up on one of these and tied at least three times in one night over the course of about 2 hours and kept throwing itself back out onto the thing. Over on this side of the catwalk, traditionally we haven't had a whole bunch of activity. However, January 30th,
right about where
we just came up leaning on that thing was where we had a spirit contact us January 30th, who apparently took the name or answered to the name of Charlie. He's very apparently strong. It was very disturbing, actually. At the end of it, there were a bunch of people up here. I'd say probably maybe 8 or 10 people with us on this side and maybe another 10 people on that side, something along them lines. Literally the EMF meters were going crazy on that side. We couldn't even really communicate because it was like they were being mobbed. All of them were pegged over there for probably at least an hour and a half while we were up here.
Just unbelievable.
We came over here because there's generally not nearly as much activity, hoping that we could maybe communicate with one or two, and it was probably only 5 or 6 minutes before we did get one of them to start manipulating one of the EMF meters, and it just went from there. When we're not on this side, we often hear footsteps as of a man walking back and forth on this side. Sometimes we've tried various things to try and entreat them to come over to the other side. We do have a lot of spirit activity on the other side, which we're going to walk across there now. But we never seem to get this individual to come over and talk to us. One of the spirits over here that we've communicated with just about since the first time that we came here seems to be a 10-year-old girl named Elizabeth. She's gave her name with a couple EVPs different times. So after dealing with her for myself for about a year, I finally bought her a doll and a tea set, hoping that she'd manipulate some of them. The last group that we had in here before the January 30th actually said that they got fingerprints on some of the wine bottle and the tea set. Now, the wine bottle is not for Elizabeth.
The second
spirit, which we've started communicating with up here, he said his first communication to us was an EVP saying, "I've got red wine." And we've kind of named him Red Wine Robert. Well, he's a very rambunctious kind of ornery character. He's a guy, he may have been a stagehand.
In places you either may or may not want touched in.
Seems to be only when the women invite him to. You know, we've definitely had some rambunctious women egging him on, and usually he'll accept the challenge.
We've had one bend over and shake her butt, and she come up out of there screaming. She said it felt like a real hand just like
grabbing
her. Yeah, right in the butt. She was screaming and hollering. And
he's also grabbed our tech manager a couple times on the pants leg, which almost sent him over the rail, because Brennan will be grumpy sometimes, and he'll be like, "Oh, I want you to do this. You know, that's not enough. I want you to do that." Well, we've told him a couple times, like, "You need to back off, Brennan," and he doesn't listen to us sometimes. So, well, we call him the goose for a reason. Let's put it that way. And Robert doesn't mind goosing him once in a while, just to show him that he's up here.
He dropped the temperature on command.
Yeah.
It was like 74 degrees. We were sitting in a chair, Brendan and I. We didn't have the trigger objects, but I felt like half my body got cold. And then we just went on to communicate and ask him if he could drop it to 65.0, half a degree at a time. Within about 2 minutes, it got to 65.0.
These two spirits will sometimes both try to communicate with you, it seems to us. Elizabeth, being a 10-year-old girl, who seems to be a 10-year-old girl, is very impatient. She will often, especially with the EMF meter, she doesn't seem to have much fine control. She'll just mug the operator of it for yeses, you know, or like, a lot of times you'll find a field around wherever the doll is, you know, or wherever a tee set is, and it won't, you can't get her to answer questions too close to it sometimes. Robert seems to be a lot more in control. He'll often give you yes or no answers, you know, if you set up a system how you want him to do it on the EMF system, you know. And usually it's actually startling how quickly he can start manipulating it and how quickly he can give you answers. At least it seems like it to me. Sometimes he'll even, if you have a, like our ghost meters will actually beep, you know, they have a volume on them. Sometimes it'll even seem like he manipulates the sound of that into words at times or close to it. So, and we have got EVPs in conjunction with the EMF readings. Now, I would recommend staying away from this wall. As you can see, there's a bunch of electrical conduit. You know, you will get some false positives on the side up here. You always will have to use your meters for yourselves and figure out, you know, where the fields are. The fields are really inconsistent. The best place we found to communicate with the spirits up here is usually over in that area where you guys are standing. You know, once you find, you know, you'll find, or at least we have found in the past a lot of times that the EMF fields will just float around up here. You know, you can actually go like this, circle one and not get anything, and find one right in the middle. There is a trap door that is open over here where this ladder comes up, so be careful, you know. Obviously there's a lot of ropes up here. Generally they aren't a problem, but like I said, when we came up, some of them seem to like to move, so watch your footing. You know, I don't want anybody to get hurt. Some of the ropes that are over here especially will sometimes move. We've had several people standing on, you know, by the rail or touching the rail report that the rail will actually vibrate under their hands. I'm not talking like somebody walking, but like if somebody's actually just standing next to them, you know, tapping on the rail or even moving the posts, even though, as you'll find, if you touch them, they are solid.